We've seen, as you guys already referenced, we've seen that despite the history that we come from, despite the truth that we come from, there is blatant misrepresentation of what Hinduism is and stands for. So actually, Lavina, I'd love to start with you because I think you mentioned it was a very powerful statement you made that you've lived in four countries and you have not experienced Hindu phobia the way the overt Hindu phobia that you've experienced in the US. And you know, you have a very visible online presence. So you're obviously sometimes caught up in the thick of the battle. So just talk to us about that a little bit. How's that experience been?
So something I've actually had to do is place comment filters on my videos because of the blatant Hindu phobia that I've gotten. People will assume, oh, like, the people who must be against your video is bringing up the inclusivity of Hinduism and LGBT acceptance of Hinduism is conservative Hindus. But surprisingly enough, I've actually gotten support from conservative Hindus. Like, in extremely conservative Hindus have been very supportive, whereas like there's a lot of just misunderstanding, and a lot of people like to use the term Hindu mizya when they talk about Hindu hate. But I really do think it's Hindu phobia because a lot of this hate and this discomfort that comes with Hinduism is the fact that Sanatan Dharma is not easy to define. It's vast. There's so many schools of thought. There's so many different ways of being a part of Sanatan Dharma. There's so many different practices, so many different views, so many different ways of accepting Sanatan Dharma that you cannot understand it. People who study Sanatan Dharma, study Sanskrit their whole life, can still not get through all of it. And I've been trying and I'm not even close. So I think a lot of the hate that comes towards Sanatan Dharma, especially in the US, comes from a place of almost fear. We don't have one book that everybody has to follow. We don't have one dogma everybody has to follow. We have our own path that we find. And the most beautiful thing I think about Sanatana Dharma is we tell everyone, we don't even think your path is wrong. If you are
Right.
part of another religion, if you're an atheist, whatever you are, there's different routes to moksha. And if you are a part of another religion, there's a reason for it. In this lifetime, there's a reason for it. Next lifetime, you learn lessons. Everybody's learning, but you have your own path to moksha, which is quite different than most belief systems. And I think that this hate and this discomfort comes from recognizing the fact that you cannot easily put us in a box. And I think in the world today, people like to put people in boxes. They like to say, okay, straight, gay, this, that, Christian, there's like a box, atheist. Whereas like a lot of spirituality, a lot of especially dharmic religions, you can't really do that with us. And I think that's where all this hate stems from. And I wish people would just be more open to just respecting each other. It doesn't matter what your belief system is. And I think that it's quite scary to me that the US is where I've seen the most Hindu phobia and the most organizations that actively come out for Hinduism, which it makes zero sense to me because if you look at our history, we are one of the only religions that have never had crusades. We've never forced converted people. Like, it's just crazy to me that there is this hate when